5 audition tips. Number 1, making bold choices. Making a bold choice is being committed, specific, and creative in your approach to the character in that scene. There is never a right way to make a bold choice, but to have the freedom to do so and to give a reading your own flavor and taste is what will separate you from others, and directors will appreciate that, and your professionalism will improve. Number 2, taking direction. The more you know your material, the better you will understand it, and the better your choices and decision-making will be. Sometimes, directors will love your first take, but want to see if you're directable. This is where your active listening skills kick in, and that is going to be key. Number 3, asking questions. Listen to what the directors are telling you, and if you're having a hard time understanding, ask questions. Directors appreciate actors who make habits of reading material beforehand. The best thing about asking questions is that even if you don't get your recording right the first time, by asking questions, it starts to get your brain moving. This will help in making bold choices when you're recording your lines. It's okay to ask the director if you're unsure about something, but don't ask just to ask. Remember, the directors aren't there to make you look like a fool. They're there to make you look good. They want you to get the job. It makes their job easier. Number 4, use your voice. All right, look, listen. This is important, people. Too many times I have seen and heard about young actors trying to have all these crazy, wacky cartoon voices. Doing those things are great and important, but they are a small minority of actors. Everyone else, 90 to 95% of the time, is gonna be using their normal voices. We pitch it up, we lower it down, we speed it up, we slow it down, or we add a dialect here and there. Don't be ashamed of your voice, because whether you know it or not, it's unique in its own way. That's why knowing your voice is important. Know how it sounds and what it can do and what it can't do. Know where your voice fits. For example, my voice is higher pitched, and I've always struggled playing deeper, older, mature characters. Look, I love it. I just know what I need to work on, and that's why I take advantage of it. Know what works best for you. Take advantage of that. That way, once you've cemented yourself in playing certain roles, you can experiment and go after the ones you're not used to playing. Number 5. The 5 W's and how. So, who are you? What kind of person, creature, thing are you? What is important to you? Who is the character you're talking to? What are you doing? What have you done? What do you plan to do? What is their relationship to him, her, or it? And what's going on? When is this scene? When is this story? When is this moment taking place? And how much time do you have to do whatever it is you're doing? Where are you physically? Where are you usually? Where would you like to be, and just where are you in the telling of the story? Why are you doing and saying that? Why aren't you saying doing something else? And finally, how does your character choose to do what he, she, or it is doing? And how is that different from how you, yourself in real life, might actually do it? And as always, low key, no cap, just saying, just super saying, I'm your boy, Riley Chase Fox, helping you know a little bit about voice acting. I'll see you in the next video. Deuces, later, bye.